Hi guys, I'm gonna show you how to install TeamViewer full version in your computer, which allows anyone to log into your computer or you can access anyone else's desktop. So first thing is I'm searching for TeamViewer and TeamViewer download. It's already typed in my computer. So just click TeamViewer download, type in that search bar and it'll give you a few links. Most probably the first link, just look for the TeamViewer download and click TeamViewer download that onto that link. And then you can see green color icon, download TeamViewer. So when you press that, it'll download the TeamViewer. You can run the TeamViewer from here. Just clicking by the download icon. We can download, run it from here, or you can, if you download from Firefox, if you can't find where it's downloaded, you can open a folder access, folder explorer, and go to downloads. It'll be here on the downloads. You can run it from there and you'll come to this same screen. So keeping it simple, I'm installing default installation, going with the default installation and selecting, if you have a license, you can go company, corporate, or personal, non-commercial. Then again, if you wanna later on, if you wanna put a the license or the access to the commercial version, you can put it later on if you want. So I'm just gonna select that and accept and finish. Then it's asking for permissions to install. I'm pressing yes, so it'll install. I'm gonna close this browser. It won't take much time. Yeah, the installation is done, and usually, yeah, it's opening by itself, and it goes to this TeamViewer information page. It'll give you few instructions how to use, so the basic things. You can close that. So this user ID and UID and the password is for you. Like anybody is accessing your computer, you need to give this ID and the passcode. And if you are accessing someone else's computer, you need to get their ID and type in the ID here. And that's their on their location, this one. And the password from their location, they need to give the password. Then after you click connect, it'll ask for you the password, then they'll give you the password, and then you can connect to their computer. That's pretty much basic, whether you want to connect to another party or anybody connecting to your computer. Only thing is, if you want to keep this running in the background, you need to do some changes. Even this password changes as you close and open the TeamViewer. At that point where you configure it to run all the time, you can set the password for that, so anybody can access without your permission, like giving a password. What you do is, for that you need to go to extras options, and it'll give you all the main options, the settings. So you tick here, start TeamViewer with Windows. So it'll ask for the password for unattended access. I'm just gonna give a password. And so that password is set. You can see in the security there's a password set here. So now you can give that password to anybody, and even if you close this, it'll run over here in the background. You can see the icon here. So if you want to access again the settings, you can go here and right click on the small icon. You can exit or go to options and change the password from here. You can change it password over here. And if you don't want to run it all the time and the window starts up, you can untick from here. That's pretty much it, the configuration of TeamViewer full version. Hope this helped for you, and if you have any questions, just put it in my comment section, and thanks for watching. Bye.